Hello, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing the end of the month love readings. I know we are a bit behind, but let's get right into your reading, Cancer. This is going to be for Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus in regards to love and romance. So let's see what Spirit has for you guys for the remaining of February going into March 2020. Now, your first card here is Passion. Passion is the essence of not just on the sexual plane, sexual energy, but it also indicates passion or desire, not just for the relationship as a whole, but to actually lust or to actually put effort in maintaining that flame of passion when it comes to your partnerships, when it comes to your marriage, when it comes to your relationship. Now, there has been a theme for a lot of the signs in regards to like maintaining that desire, maintaining, like igniting the flame. For some of you guys, it could even be rekindling the passion. And again, we're seeing this play out in this reading as well. So I think that in retrospect, the end of February going into March, it's going to be very important for us to really tune into what is it that we desire? What is it that we're passionate about? What is it that motivates us? Not just on a grander scale, but also with relationships. It takes time. It takes effort to cultivate a relationship. For those of you guys that are new to your partnerships, those of you guys that have been in a long-term committed relationship, the everyday life consumes us. We work, we get home from work, we kind of forget about our partner. We put energy towards our children, our responsibilities, cooking, etc. So what they're saying here is it's time for us to take a bit of a step back and actually cultivate or actually put effort and energy in the seduction process and tapping into our, you know, natural instinct, our animalistic instincts of igniting and desiring and wanting or lusting. So passion is going to be very, very important for the month of March, and it's going to be taking center stage. Now, your next card here is romantic feelings. Your feelings are real and worth exploring. So with the passion, again, we're talking about romance. Not just necessarily like taking your partner on a date, but actually romance on the scale of maintaining that passionate, intense, you know, kind of like when you're in the beginning stages of like dating someone that you're very excited about getting to know them, that you're really wanting to really delve into, you know, what they like, what they're passionate about. So what they're telling you here, especially those of you guys that have been in a long-term committed relationship, it's time for us to revisit those feelings of in the beginning. Yes, we've gone through difficulties. Yes, it's been, you know, we've overcome a lot of obstacles or have overcame a lot of obstacles. But for the remaining of the month of February going into March, it's going to be very important to connect with your partner on a deeper level. And this primarily has a lot to do with communication, communicating, but as well as seduction. If you can see in this card, there is kind of like, to me, it reminds me of the first stages of romance where it's such a desire, such a strong need and desire to be around your partner or to kind of be out in public and just giving each other that look, you know, that look of when I get home, I'm just going to rip out your clothes, that type of energy. So what they're saying here is, again, it is very important to maintain that romantic energy, not just solely depend on your partner to do that, but as well as take initiative is what they're saying. Now, your next card here is playfulness. So revisiting how it is when we first start with relationships, keeping it playful. Like I said, you know, it's hard work when it comes to partnerships, especially when we have so many responsibilities on everyday basis. But find that inner child within you, Cancer, and really tap into that, as well as, you know, the playfulness, the joking around, the you know, randomly spanking the butt of your partner, that type of energy. I feel that what they're saying here is really take it to the level of what it was initially in the beginning, or what it was initially, what was the reason why you fell for your partner, and revisiting that. By doing so, this is going to strengthen your partnership. It's going to solidify it, make it stronger, as well as serve for your partner as well, to start to really focus on the past experiences and how it was when you guys first came together. That's something that is very beautiful, and it's highly needed in this time. Now, for those of you guys that are currently single, what they're saying here is that when it comes to relationships, it's very important not to jump to conclusions. So what I mean by that is, when you're dating, or if you're dating and going on random dates, learn to be playful with dating, okay? So when I mean playful, what they're saying is, when you go on your first date or second date, don't go with any expectations. When we have expectations and they usually don't meet our expectations, what happens? We kind of lose interest, or we're quickly like not interested because we had such high expectations. And what they're saying is, learn to be playful with this. You know, remind yourself, I'm going on this date, let it be what's going to be. If it's great, it's amazing and blessed be. If it's not, it's okay. This is just the route that it's going to take me. If it's not this person, it's going to be the route that's going to take me to the person that is right. So you can take off all that heavy burden of going into a date or going into getting to know someone, expecting them to like really start talking about serious monogamous relationship when you're just getting to know them. Passion is very important, but not just passion when it comes to getting to know the person, but be vocal about what really ignites you, what you're really passionate about. That's also going to give you a three-dimensional perception on their part of you as a person. So again, it's very important for you to really learn to be playful when it comes to dating. Don't take it so seriously. Let it happen organically. Don't try to force anything. This is going to be very important for you guys for now all the way till the beginning of March, okay? So I hope you guys enjoyed these readings, and let's go on to the next.